Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome to the 1960s. Here we are in South Africa for a round one of the GT Revival 1960s Championship. Check it out. We are here at the 76 version of Kyalami in South Africa, where the round two of the 1976 Formula One race was held, won by Niki Lauda. And today, we are in for a treat. We have a huge field. Let's just get a look at this leaderboard here. You kind of see who's doing what. We are just getting ready to head into quali. But take a look at this. I think we've got about 24 drivers today. See some of the times they're set here. 1:28:26. Missouri has that time right now. As we are looking at Gilles De Silva and that beautifully painted car that I think he's in the Austin there. Going to take us a couple times to get familiar with these cars, what they are. Yeah, that is the Austin Healey. I was right. It's going to be a guessing game a little bit here. These cars are so cool. If you haven't checked this mod out, I would suggest you give it a rip, man. It is amazing fun. There's some weird stuff going on with it. If you'll see here some of these views, see if you'll see the collar on a few of them, but not on all of them. So we will sort that out as time goes by. But with that said, we are about ready to go into the qualification session. And again, let's see. This is round one. And get a quick look at the schedule here to sort of see what's coming up. Aha. The next round will be Oak Park 60s. That'll be something else. Then Alenius Montreal full. Round four, Eiffel Schumstrick, whatever the hell, however you're supposed to say that. I have no freaking clue. And then Longford for round five. And then finally, we're going to finish this series up on the mountain. So that will be something to behold, let me tell you. Let's see, I wanted to go over, there's a couple rules for this race. This race will be 60 minutes. I think we're using two times fuel, as we are now, we're in the quali. It's two times fuel and I think three times tire wear because these tires are made of stone. So the admins decided to let's make it exciting and force a couple pit stops here. So it's three times tire wear, two times fuel, just to force a pit stop. As we see these guys getting ready. Now this is going to be a new deal with a private qualifying, so there won't be any traffic. As I believe that is Mr. Woody heading out there in the Cobra. Let's get the little box up here so we can kind of get an idea of what's going on. And I'll bring up the tower so we can watch the times come down. That is Neil Wood, just as I thought. What a glorious mod. I did a couple laps. I tried to drive all the cars. I didn't have quite enough time. I think I got through six or so of them. And man, what a blast. Holy smokes. Let's see. Mazurk, who put out that quick lap, is also in the Cobra, so let's check him out. Let's see if the Cobra's got that weird. I think the Cobra, yeah, see, it's got a clean cockpit, so we won't have the collars in this. But look at that dashboard, look at the detail. What an amazing mod. So, hey, we're in the 60s, man. There's going to be some drifting, there's going to be door banging. These cars can take a beating and keep on going, so it's going to be a really fun, great race. And I hope we can get everybody that's in it to actually finish. I am taking a look. We do have 25 total as we're looking at Mazurek here. He's going to come out for his start of his first time lap. Look at that. Snake eyes. That snaky. Again, it really likes with the eyes. I love it. Cobra is a fan favorite here. I did try the Bazzarini, the 5300 GT. It's a little bit longer. It's pretty fun to drive too, though. I found that both Ferraris, there's two Ferraris, the GTO and the Swayback. They're both the 250s, and you will see those as we go here. They were pretty quick when I was test driving, but I'm a slow driver. I think I did see Gianni Gutierrez doing some practice runs last night in this very Cobra, and he was getting into 128. So let's see what Missouri can do here. got a time lap going. Coming up this section here, it's, you could take most of the stuff wide open, but you really got to be careful in here. And then this turn here, I think it's, this is the hardest braking zone, I think, right here. You got to get ready for this tightness. You can see, it's kind of super. You time, get that just right, keep you out of the dirt. You could recognize that from the modern at Kyalami as it comes down. However, it hangs a right up here down the main straight instead of going left at the top like the new Kyalami does. And here is that last turn up to the home straight. If you can hit this little right-hander here, you could get on the throttle quick. Down the home stretch here. Stretch the legs of these babies. Here he comes, he's purple. Oh, but looks like Taylor has put in a 28-4, but let's see what... With Westy's two behind him, but let's see what Zurich here is going to cross the line. Oh, and he's coming. Here we go, we go. Ah, he's in third so far. All right. So, let's jump down the list here. Here is Giuseppe in the Ferrari. Baldoni. He's coming across the line. Green to green to green. Estrella putting in a nice time up there. Smythe up there on the leaderboard. They're starting to come across now. Let me turn on the clock so we kind of get an idea what the heck going on here. Yeah, okay. So it was a 15-minute session like I thought. See, Baldoni gets himself up into sixth. See who else we can look at here. Ole Bazzone also in the Ferrari. I believe this is the GTO, not the Swayback, but I could be wrong. Nope, I think it is the Swayback. The only way to tell is to find one that's not the Swayback. Green and green, I'm looking for some purples. Oh, let's check up, let's jump to Johnny Gutierrez, because he is purple in that Cobra. He was, well, not in that line. So he does put himself in third. So this lap is off. I missed that. I'm trying to look here. Nick Westy. And Merrick. Look at these skins. I love Merrick's skins. The MRG Racing Team. They've got some beautiful skins for this race. Look at that car. The whole team has the theme. Man, it's really great. Look at that Cobra, man. It just, I can't say enough how amazing this mod is. It's so fun to drive. And I don't know, I think, see, the Cobra's got the clean dashboard. Yeah. Some, like some of the other ones, you'll see the block view as we go through here. But America 130 does his best time there. Keeps him, he's in the top 15 anyway, so. We got Krylov, looks like he has taken pole in the Mustang. Look at this, a 127.622 in that Ford-powered Mustang. You gotta love that. I think this has a 289 V8 in it. And then the Chevy, of course. 65 coupe. I think Ed Jones is in that. So let's find that. It's Ed Jones. I think he's driving that. He's got it parked. All right. Ben Summers. Also in Ferrari. Warren Martin, another Ferrari driver. So there's the, now that's the Swayback, I believe. I have no idea. I'll learn. But yeah, that's got a clean dash as well. He's coming in for the pits. So let's see, host Van der Geese. Oh, there's Smythe. See, there's that MRG theme. Those Cobras are really looking good. It's gonna be quite the race. Well, who else came? Estrada, Matthias, he's parked. Now he's in that. Look at that. That's the Gande, that team. That is that Bazzarini car. Really crazy looking car. And here's Freddie Hill. Now he is also MRG. He's got his own skin. It's a little bit different. Really kind of cool looking. Look at that rivet job on the patchwork metal, but has that orange theme going with it for the MRG. So I think that is their theme. But man, these Cobras are something else. Well, let's check Krill in that Mustang. See the Ford putting it up on the pole. That is something else. Let's see what we got for him in the dash. Yeah, we got a little bit of collar action, but that's okay. This one's not so bad because he's purple in Sector 1 here. Let's follow him and see if he can even beat his time of a 27.6. Just in contrast, when the 76 of Formula race was here, their times are like 1:16, so that's about 10 seconds faster than these babies. But hey, these are vintage. Well, of course, at the time they're not, but he's purple and purple. He's going to set himself up here. As he comes across the line, he beat that 1:27.6, and he takes up his tenth up at 1:27.4. So great lap by Krill. And Michael Mazurek in that Cobra. Snake Eyes, he's on an out lap. Let's find out Philip Pilcher here in the Merc. So not a lot of Mercs in this race. I drove it around. It was pretty cool. But what a beautiful car. Let's check it. It's pretty simple. Left that thing around. It does drift really good too on this track. Is one of the ones I had a blast with. I couldn't stop driving. It was so fun. Yeah, see, he's got the collar as well. So I don't know. The modder is so amazing on this. We've been in communication with the modder, and he has been fixing little things here and there as the updates come out. So we got to hand it to him for staying on it and helping us out. Let's see, Rizzy's another MRG driver, so he's got the blue and orange theme. That Rizzy is the Cobra, and he's got it off, and then he's gonna put a ding in that. Randy's not gonna be happy about that. He's gonna do a little body work, but like I say, these cars are built like tanks. It's gonna take a lot to knock you out of this race. So hopefully, we'll get everybody to finish in this. I'm looking for Pilcher. There's Philip. Yep, he's in the Merc. Did Sumners ever come out? Sumners is out. Yep, he's in the Ferrari. Jones is going to keep it in the pit, looks like. And that's fine. He'll come out and do his battling. Paul Upham, what's he driving on? He's another Mustang. He's got himself on the top 15 there. At least about 1.9 off the pace, but more American car. Let's say, well, Woody's in the Cobra. Right there in 12th position. Ricardo, he's parked. Let's see, Mateus, he's parked. All right, Freddie Hill, the MRG guys. And Cobras, he's on an out lap. We are under 5 minutes to go here. Pretty much a flat-out circuit. Let's see if he gets a little drift going here. That whole first sector there is pretty wide open, and then you start using the brakes here. This is the technical part. You can really throttle steer these cars good too. Really, really fun. There's downshifting. That keep it off the dirt. There you go. And then down into the little off-camber chicane slope. And as you can see, you know, the new Kyalami hangs the left right here, but we're hanging a right for the old start-finish. He's purple in Sector 2. Let's see if Freddie can bump himself up. Currently in 6th. And he does. He puts himself up in the 4th ball. Only about a half a second off of that blistering Krylov pace in the Mustang. Nicely done, Freddie. So that's Kai Severstein. He's parked. Christian Dollar parked. But a lot of these guys choosing to just sit it out. Rizzy, looks like he's putting some fresh shoes on. There's Lorne in that Ferrari. 50. I think this is the SWB. Maybe not. I don't know. I gotta find a SWB, but it. And here's Fields. I love it. The Austin Healey. Look at this paint job. It's just very fitting for the era. Gotta love Fields and his paint. Does such an amazing job. And the Merrick boys did all that whole teamwork. I don't know who's doing their skins for them, but they're fantastic. Up on the righty here. Is Krylov still sitting across the leaderboard? Get him working that steering wheel.
Oh, Griffin.
Yeah. Fighting it a little bit. He's yellow and yellow. But just a really cool looking car. As we are down, we are under 2 minutes to go here. So Gilles is not gonna move himself. But let's check out Anthony Talmitier. Okay, this is the sway back. Ta-da! Okay, we have resolution. Now I know. You can check that long back on that baby. So this is the SWB Ferrari 250. See that long tail end on it. Both the Ferraris for me, when I was just screwing around, felt like they were just hugging the road. They had really good grip. I felt like I could get through those more technical sections. I could hold the line and get on the apex a little easier with the Ferrari. So we'll see what happens here as we see that Ford is still on top. But Gutierrez, as let's watch Tony here as he's is green and green to see if he can better his own time and jump ahead of Freddy. And he does not. So here we go. There is Gutierrez, who's put himself up in second as the time has expired here. So I believe that's it, everybody. This is the leaderboard. You're looking at it right there. Krylov, Gutierrez, Mazurek, Hell, Talvitier, Taylor Wood, Vandergeese, Baldoni, and Estrella are the top 10. Then Smythe, Upham, Cingati, Merrick, Dauger, Summers, Rizzi, Martin, Da Silva, and Winham in that bottom area. There, of course, we got the middle right there. Let me set the order is set. There we go. Doing my little software thing here. And let's find a little bit of a scenic shot here. I know there's some shots of the track. There we go. There we go. Okay. Quali is over. And now they're going to have about a 5 minute session here to get their wits about them. And maybe they were going low fuel. Stop the tires. I don't know. I didn't look to see if there's a tire change of compound. I just know that it's 3 times tire wear. So, and 2 times fuel. So we're going to force a pit stop in this 60-minute adventure back in time as we go retro. Again, let's have a look at what is coming up here. There's your schedule again. In 2 weeks, on the 21st, if my calendar's right, we'll be at Old Park. So don't miss that as time is going forever here. Take a look around the track. Down that main straight. Okay, session's changing. Getting a little bit of action there. So here we go. They're going to head out now. Look at that pit lane. 25 brave souls here today. Actually, 26. We did have our last minute join, so we got 26. Very good, very good. The pit lane's a busy place. See these classic cars heading out. Got to get these camera views down. Here comes one of the MRGs. Let's get rid of this. Great sound in this mod too. Give it a listen. Like I said, it's so much fun. There's the vet. Going into the pits. Horsepower there, man. I drove that thing around. It's got some guts, let me tell you. There is that Krylov pole sitter. Oh, man. I remember these cars. Believe it or not, everybody, I was around. Yeah, dating myself, but I am pretty freaking old. The only thing older than me is dirt. But yeah, I remember going to Riverside Raceway when I was a kid, sitting with my pops watching all the stock cars, Dan Gurney, AJ Foyt, all those guys. And we had a Mustang, and it's like this. That's what it looks like. There's your dash right there. Really cool car. Then my brother actually had a Shelby Cobra when he came back from Nam. He spent all his combat pay on a sparkle blue Mustang GT500, what it was, with the pinned hood. What a beast that thing was. There is Barrett Erickson chiming in. That Bizzarini. So let's get a look at that Bizzarini's. I want to see that. The Bizzarini there, that dashboard. That's pretty cool. All right. He's parked it. Taylor, hey, these guys are all parking it. And that is because I think we got a minute left. Not in the pit. Yeah, let's check out Philip Pilcher. Yeah, getting it done in that Merc. Alrighty, alrighty, alright. Estrella. Also in that Dagon, Bizzarini. Bizzarini. You know, the way that's spelled B-I-Z-Z-A-R-R-I-N-I. Bizzarini, Bizzarini, Bizzarini. What a car, man. Look at that thing. This is, that's where I had trouble with that car, was right in that section there, that last, that section three, the S turn, the downhill, uphill S turn. And that was, of course, after driving, I think, the Ferrari. It just, this one just felt a little heavier to me, and I had to really line it up to get that apex. But fun car to drive, nonetheless. All right, ladies and gentlemen, time is up in warm-up. So we are about to hear the most famous words in all of sim racing, if you're an R-Factor 2 fan, from the way, way, way back. We will hear it. One of my favorite sounds ever. I've told you this story before. When my family hears that sound, they know to shut all the doors and just hold on to something in case, you know, it's a bad start. They'll hear bad things.
Non-essential personnel leave the grid now.
That is a classic. I'm just going to record that and have it forever just in case something ever happens. All right, we're taking the grid. We are having a standing start, so the lights are going to go down. We are off and running on the green. There is no formation lap. It's going to be every man for himself. Katie, bar the door. Let's see if we can make it into the super drift turn one. I'm going to try and keep up with this stuff. You know how impossible it is without a track map. But we're here, 26 cars on the grid. We're about there, and we are off. And here is round one. It's going to the inside on the start. There, we get the Mustang is taken out in front. Second gears in the Cobra trying to hang tight. Let's stick with the back, just in case. Looks like everybody's clean in the tour. Look at that lead that the Mustang has already. They're coming through. They're all getting through. One, come on, everybody can make it. Yes, yes, everybody's gotten through. Oh, no, we've got somebody flipping over. We've got cars piled up. Where are they? Who is it? Is that Erickson? It was. Oh, no, Barrett. Oh, what a rough start for Barrett. Saw cars flying in the air. Who was that with him? Was that... I think it was, yeah, it was Ricardo. So Ricardo and Barrett getting lit. There's more yellows. Holy smokes, what else is going on? It looks like Ricardo might have damage, or he's waiting for even though up here in the middle, we've got yellows. Oh, it's another little kiss and tell. They're bumping and grinding. Holy smokes, everybody hang on. Look at this side-by-side action already. Crazy to watch. As we come around, and Grills got caught up by Gutierrez. This is the pointy end now. As we're coming around to complete one lap, that Mustang is out in front with two Cobras hot on their tails. Freddie Hill in third place, Gutierrez in second. Jumping down, Rob Tony Talavitie duking it out here. Oh, heaven. Hang on, everybody. Hang on to your dang feet. Evander Geese and Talavitie in a battle. Meanwhile, back here in the Corvette, here's another battle. Wyndham Jones duking it out. Wyndham's got it. About a second behind. And Ali Basso's right there in that stuff, too. So there is Ali. Okay, let's bring up the tower after the lag fest. There we go. There is your leader. And there is the difference. These guys are just roaring through. It's Ferrari on Ferrari. Yeah. Good stuff, good stuff. Back to the tippy end. We got a challenge here. Ready. Closing in on Gutierrez and Krylov. Listen to these babies. Oh yeah, you can see them coming up in order. They're duking it out for the pole. Krylov sets a 27.54, and it looks like Reddy's going to the outside on Gutierrez. Johnny's going to have the inside for turn one. Now let's see what happens here. Cobra versus Cobra. Yeah, yes. Reddy had nosed it out there, but yes, Gutierrez gets right under him. Beautiful move there. You can see they were drag racing from the start there. Nicely done, nicely done. Coming up into the tight section here. A little wheel action. Oh yeah, hard on the brakes. Look at Krylov out there in that Mustang. Gets tight right here. The heaviest braking zone on the track right there, and they've all made it through. Okay, let's jump back to the trick here. Got a good scratch with the snake man, except Baldoni's right on his tail. And you can see Smythe back there. Oh, we got a little bit of debris flying there. We got somebody off. Who's that in the background? Oh, my heavens. I can't see. Is that Kai? No. The filter? I don't know. Wow. It was Taylor. No. No, we got our first casualty. Robin Taylor is out of this race. Good heavens. Hang on to your seats, everybody. Oh, man, that was brutal. And there's Ollie with Randy. Ed Jones right there in that vet. Look at that vet power coming up straight. The Porsche back there in two behind the Ferrari. Up at the tippy top, Pierre's still under pressure from hell. Give him hell, hell. Meanwhile, for the 13th fourth, we got the Giuseppe, or Gillis, and the Silva, and Pilcher. And here is Jones in that vet. Let's get a look at that vet. Yeah. Now the vet only has four gears. Oh, is they're taking it wide? He's taking it wide. He's going to get a spot. Oh! Great job staying out of the way. As we see, Ericsson is in the pits, I'm sure, making repairs after that. But remember, there is 3x tire wear, 2x steel, so these guys are going to have to stop. But the action is non-stop here. There goes that vet. Look at that thing. He pulls away with that horsepower. Now, it only has four gears is what I'm about to say. Most of these cars are five speeds, but the vet is a four speed. And nothing but pure American muscle right there. Maybe not so good in the turns. Not quite the dancer that some of these Euro models are. So he's going to get out in the corners, but he's got the muscle to get through on the straight. So this is a great little battle we got going on here. Jones hanging it out there. Summers just giving him everything he can as they're duking it through. But meanwhile, Giuseppe and Westy battle here. Baldoni holding off Dogger in that Cobra. Put the pressure. Westy out in front of both of these guys. I'm sorry, not Westy, but the third. That Ferrari. Krylov just another quickest lap. This guy's unbelievable in that Ferrari. Meanwhile, let's go back here. We've got the Merrick battle. Here is your battle in the back. This is the 19th position here, challenging now. Mr. Upham in that other Mustang, I believe. Gets through the carnage. Oh, so such a bummer about Taylor. Ericsson Derrickson back out. Yeah, here comes Derrickson now. So, Barrett, one of our local drivers, fantastic driver. Really unfortunate that he got dinged up on that first lap, but he is a fighter. He will be in this thing at the end. He might be a few laps down, but he is going to score points. Okay, well, back up in the Wesley battle. Wesley and Smythe trying to close in. This is a great pack. Woody is leading this. There is Neil Wood with Berserk behind him in the Snakemobile. Cobra versus Cobra. But then, right behind him is it's a crack. It burns. Spike and Dogger. Dogger gets close around. That was unfortunate. He's patiently waiting for the traffic to get himself back in the action. And there he goes. Like I say, these cars, this is good old steel from the 60s, so it's hard to take these babies up. And I believe that's Erickson going around him now. You see a little bit? Yep, that's what I thought. Okay. Meanwhile, because the battle's coming up the front, Missouri gets in front of Woody after all that. Car behind him. It's a Cobra versus Cobra. And one Cobra's got teeth. Oh, that was unfortunate back there, but hey. Told you guys it's going to be a fist fight, and that's exactly what it is. These guys getting it sideways. Driftmobiles. Here we go, coming up to the braking zone. Downshift, trying to hold that apex and keep yourself off of the dirt right here. So the first 10 minutes of this race have produced nothing but complete action and chaos. Meanwhile, here is the battle. 16. Up of the other Mustang. Coming up on that Austin Healy from the City Tones. Up of gets a little bit sideways there. Silva. Let's see if we got some views here. Ah. You can listen to that. Austin. The James Bond car, the Austin Healy. Nothing new at the front. Freddy's still in here. Johnny's second grill off. I guess we should take a look up there. But we do have a great battle here with Jones and Ollie. Jones started us that V8 power on that Corvette. There comes that muscle, I'm telling you. But let's see what happens. Hang on to it. As you see, Ollie is the inside of this. The advantage comes back. That vest has got so much muscle. Way to hang on to it, Jones. Nicely done. Now we're coming up to the braking sections. See what happens there. Swing it to the outside. Ollie's taking a look. Where the advantage would go back. Absolutely. Look at that. That's pulling away. Great job, Ed Jones. Muscling that thing around. And now here's down to mid again. Where did it go? That is his last little apex. And then it's go time right here. So let's see. He might even be able to catch Pilcher up there. That's Pilcher in front of him. Alright. Stop. You can see the gap increasing now. That American muscle. Woody finds himself in 7th, Baldoni in 8th. Well, I haven't looked in on John Vandergies in the Ferrari, comfortably in 5th place, no stress, cruising around, but up in front of him, Davide. Yeah, it's getting a little bit up the business there. Coming around. currently in fourth. Okay, back to this battle, the 16 and 17. This is a three-way battle. The Ferrari, the Austin, the Mustang.
Look at that Austin.
Right in the back of that Mustang. They're both going wide, and that's going to open the door for the Ferrari. It looks like Ben's going to try and take advantage. He's on the inside, hard on the brakes as he comes down the hill. Oh, man. Good racing here. Some nail biting stuff here, I'm telling you.
Oh, it's Austin. Silva.
Silva lost it. Gills. Oh. Come on, get it back in there, Gills. There you go. Oh, that was a tough break for Gills. But he's back in it. He lost a few spots there for 21st. And that made Rizzi happy. He got himself a spot back. And so did Merrick, I believe. As Gogger's going around, he has the inside of Scobra versus Scobra. But down to turn one here. Oh, he gets the advantage. Might be a little body damage there on Rizzi. I think he had a little bit of contact back there. But, yeah, we don't know. Meanwhile, Mike looking to take 10 from Isaac. Coming into the braking zones. Done it. You can lose it right here, and it's going to get ugly. Hang on. Last little apex, and then get on the gas. Get your butt up that hill. Quickly, quickly, quickly. There you can see Westy holding on to ninth right in front of these guys. About 15 minutes in, I'm wondering how they're doing on tires as far as pit stops goes. These guys are going for position right here. Ty going inside. He's closing it wide. Mike, right back there, waiting for a mistake. These guys, the chase is on. Hit him from both ends here. Died. Trying to apply the pressure. This mid-pack battle is just intense. Alright, let's see what happens here. Coming down the straight. Who's got the juice? It's Westy leading the pack. Mike coming up the middle, looks like Westy's getting iced it out on the inside there. There's some speed pills. Holy smokes. Was that Ty that took that spot? Yes. In the DB4. It's showing some horsepower there. Nice move coming down the straight. It looks like he's stretching his legs a little bit now. Mike saying, hey man, I'm coming for you. Got to keep all the wheels on the pavement here. Especially in these babies. Got off. Is that the Healy or the Martin? No, that is... Yes, it is. The DB4, I believe. Which is the James Bond car from the famous 60s movies. Alright, let's take a peek down at the back here. Erickson, a lap down, but battling. Four laps to be exact. County. Like I said, he'll be there in the end. Put some points on the board. And Da Silva, with that incident ops, finds himself in 22nd. Rizzi, currently 19th. But there's cars in pursuit. But I believe that is, Yeah, that's Barrett laps down. Don't mind the name tags. All right, the mid-pack battle is still going on here as these guys are duking it out for the top 10. Westy out in front. Pilcher. It's Mike. Holy smokes. So Westy got himself back up there. But you can see that, or Filter ahead of them, running away from them after that pass. They are. There is Ty. I'm sorry. It's Pilcher in the Merc hanging on. And meanwhile, up here at the pointy end, it looks like Zurich has found his way in the top five, and it's Commander Hiss trying to take that fourth spot away. And I believe these guys might be coming up on the last one. There's that Talvitie out in front of these guys. In pursuit of Mandrakis here, heading into the heavy braking zone. I'm thinking the tires got to be getting pretty slippery here as we're getting towards the halfway point, plus fuel could be an issue. Ah, the sound of those covers is just so cool. And here is WTA, just ahead there in third, the last step on the podium being held by Tony at this time. And Gutierrez, I feel him, he's coming in for the pit. So there is the first of the leaders stopping in the Mustang, and that puts Gutierrez in the lead of this race. As Krylov changes on four tires and fuel, get himself out the rest of the way. I'm curious to see where he is going to come out, so we will keep an eye on him. And also Mazurk is coming in. So there's the starting our first couple guys coming in for our man. It's not mandatory, but it is if you want to finish the race because you need fuel. So everybody's moving up a spot, but we will see what happens as Gutierrez holds the lead of this race. But meanwhile, the Westy battle. Okay, you got another one coming in. So that was Missouri. Westy's in. Okay. Ty's coming out. Where is there is Grill coming out in seventh position. So after the stop, he comes out seventh. Not too bad to see a little bit of yellow action as there's our leader, Gutierrez. Calvitier, some 3 seconds back. Vandergeest. Meanwhile, Nogger and Merrick are having a little bit of a run here. As we got Upham and Lauren Martin are also in the pits, as well as Da Silva. So, three more stoppers as these guys do get out here. Coming up, these guys go up a little bit, but just temporarily until they have to pit themselves. I wish there was a way to see the fuel gauges here. It'd be really fun to be able to watch the fuel go down, but everybody's tank is half full. Default, half full. All right, these guys duke it out. So Woody stopped. They're in the pits, Moore's in the pits. So Gutierrez still coming around. Let's see if he stops this lap. They're all starting to come in now. And I'm sure it's more than desperation, it's necessity. Oh, we have a little bit of incident there. Gutierrez. Somebody had an off back there. Yeah, it was Westy. Scott Weston. Sorry for the labels, but I gotta kind of keep track too. Alright, the whole mid-pack has pitted now. We got Woody should be coming out now. Winham. Let's see where that puts Krylov. Krylov is slowly climbing as the other cars pit. Finds himself in fourth with Cyberstein. Kai's on his tail, but I don't believe Kyle has pitted yet. Let's see if I can get this. Change the stops. No refresh here. Yeah, not working very well. So we'll just forget that for now. So the top 10 battle, here's Winham. Dogger. Woody, I believe, is in front of them in ninth right there. Yep, there is Neil Wood, currently in ninth. And coming fresh out of the stop. So fresh tires and gas. Meanwhile, I think I hear it's Mateus and Paul Upham. So 13 seconds apart from each other, but there is Paul. Let's find Estella. Mark in the pits. Oh, there's Martin there. Okay, so we got it. Low attack 23, 24. Another Austin. Gagati. Good looking car. And Dogger here puts some pressure for the top 10. Woody's holding 9th in this tour, fighting out for 10th in another Cobra versus Cobra battle. Looking for the inside, he's going to make a move. Can he get through? Not so fast, says Winham. Oh, he's got an apex there. Down the twisty chicane. Oh, everything can go to hell in a handbag right here if you're not careful. Oh, look at that run he's got on him now. Coming up the hill, he might have got on the inside. He's looking at the inside, he's got a nose. Can he keep it tight? This is going to be a drag race for position. I don't think he's going to fix it at that. Winham. Winham's coming in for his pit stop, so that's going to leave that battle out. So it's Gutierrez, and I guess he's in front again. Krylov, there he is. Finds himself out front once again. There is Gutierrez. So it's a 100-second gap, though. No DRS in these cars. Place he'd be flapping it. But, wow, what a battle this has been so far. Great stuff by these guys. Really fun mod. The Baldoni battle. The heat within 2 seconds. Dogger. But Gutierrez getting a little trite here. Here we go. He's letting Krill know that he's back there. I'm telling you, Gutierrez is fearless. This guy, I love this guy. I love the way this guy drives. Shawnee Gutierrez from Southern California, just like me. Roots, baby. Skateboards. We were the first kids to skate pools back in the, 70s. I'm older before. I'm old. I was around for these cars. Not going to say how old I was, but, yeah. Anyway, Gutierrez hates, like, any car. Downforce? What's downforce? Wings on one. If anything's got down for us, he just throws these things around. He's so good on the brakes. He's just a really, really good sim racer. So if anybody can catch Krill, it's going to be Johnny. Oh, Winham's got a penalty. What did you do, Stefan? What did you do? You were speeding in the pits. He's coming out. That's got to be what it was. Speeding in pit lane for Stefan. He's going to have to do a drive-through. That's going to make Estrella happy. Meanwhile, Westy and Jones, Philip Pilcher. And Jones. Who's that? Is that Ty? Ty's out in front there. Yeah. Came out in front. And the duty four. The Pilcher. As we are just about at the halfway mark here. So this guy's pitted just before halfway. I'm wondering if they're going to have enough. Or if the tires are going to be toast by the time the last minute or so. Just check it down. They hit it before halfway. And I can't tell if it was fuel. I can't tell you if it was fuel or tires that forced the pit stop. But no, it was one of them, or both. This girl off is kind of irking that lead out to almost 2 seconds now. So as I was talking about Johnny, he's going to have to do some of that magic to close that gap. Meanwhile, the mid-pack battle, here they are. These 9 through 12 are all running up right here. Baldoni out in front of them there in 8. Woody consistently in that top 10. There is in that Cobra. He is currently in 7th place. Vanity's in 6th, just ahead of him, some 5 seconds. So the pit stops really shook it up here as we get back to this battle of the American pits. All right, so I don't know if that's his second stop or not, but I like that pit stop with this much time left. He can have a little bit of fresh tires. So should produce a good finish for Randy, that team MRG, with those amazing liveries. That dash, there we go. Ah, that Merck's getting a little slippery up there. Touchy section right here, especially for the bed. This is where I had trouble with the bed, but I have trouble with it. They're bringing it up the hill. Past the halfway point. So again, we've only got one car out, and that is Robin Taylor, who was out after, I think, he's 13 laps down. So really bummed to see Ram go. Erickson is some 4 laps down, but still in it. Gatte right here. Nice little fight there with Lauren. And she puts it off. That is Martin and Tagate. Wow, Ed Jones again in that. Opening up the throats of that. I think that it's a 427 in there. No, that's the Cobra. Doesn't show the spec of the vet in the stack right here, but it's probably the Chevy 350, I would imagine. 357, I don't know. But this mid-pack battle with Jones is about the tightest grouping that we have at this 27 and a half minute mark. Let's take a peek up to the top again here. Gutierrez is some 3 seconds back now. So Thrill really flexing his muscles in that American muscle eyes. Gutierrez gets it a little sideways. Having a little fun with that. And then Freddie Hell is another 5 seconds back. We're in front of Zurich. But I want to know how far off he is. He's 11 off the lead. And Gutierrez is up the lead, so there you go. 8 or 9 seconds back of second place. But meanwhile, back in the vet battle. So Severson's got a rear view mirror full of Ed Jones in that American Muscle vet. Jones has done a great job of keeping that thing in it, man. No, the early development of the Ray Corvette. They had a little trouble when they first came out with the design because the front end was like a wing and it would lift. You would actually lose. Oh, she's going through the front end because it's a little wide. Neighbors can take the wide. That's going to allow Lenore. He opens the door for Jones to jump in the nose. He's got the head into the twisty parts. Oh, this could get ugly.
Jones hits with the pass.
Brilliantly done. Nice job, American Muscle pulls through. Take that, 007. Yeah, it looks like Kai got a little bit wide and opened the door, and Jones just took advantage. Put the car where it's going to be. Nicely done. Moves himself up into ninth. Top 10. Nope, we got a yellow in sector one. Where is it? Third place, Freddie Hill. Looking good. Gutierrez. Where are you, Johnny? Still looking good. He is coming up on some traffic, though. That lead is still about 3 seconds. So here is the back of the pack here. Martin and Susie. And there is Giuseppe. Or Gills, I'm sorry. Gills. And that awesome 60 paint job. Getting the blue flag. Nicely done. Guys, are these guys not battling? No, okay. Lauren was getting the blue flag. My bad. Very nice. All right. Meanwhile, Silver Center pitcher. Here we go. Trying to hold on as Jones got through. Now, Pixler's looking for a way to get through. That DB4 has got the muscle. Closing in a little bit here. We can get this apex and get on the gas. Got anything to come back with. I can tighten a row here. Oh, the battle for third place is tightening up. Let's take a look at this. She's only a second and a half back. Got some lap cars in the way. Oh, ready. No, that was not in the playbook. Well, he was a second. Oh, and he's doing it again, and he almost takes him out. Stay clear, stay clear. Give him room, give him room. Don't cut him off. Oh, Freddy gets it all wrong in sector one at the end. Knocks himself all the way back to sixth. Oh, what a heartbreaker. The VTA's pretty happy about that. Meanwhile, Dogger and back to are going to get it out here from 15 to 16. Everybody else is staring clear. So they're hitting 23 minutes to go. Boy, there's a lot of action in this race. I tell you, it's hard to keep up with. What's up? Look at that. Nice move. Like Dogger gets himself out. Back. They are. So there's 14. Oh, that's the sixth place car. That's Freddie Hill. He's got himself in between a lap car sandwich right there after his little mishap. So he's making up for it, and they let him through. I'm sure they're getting blue flags, so good on you. Very good. But meanwhile, Westy and Smythe are having a little run here. Westy's trying to find a way around. He's riding through the traffic on the other side. Oh, can you get a nose? Smythe gives it up. Nice move. Nick Westy putting it on the inside, taking that spot. Nicely done. Let's see if Smythe has anything for him. Coming back. And who is that? That's not the leader behind him, is it? It might be. Check real quick. Yes, it is. So 10th and 11th is about to get lapped. The pace is pretty even, though, so it's going to be hard to get around these lappers. They're going to have to let it go. But the pace is so close, so, you know, it kind of busts up the battle. But, you know, you don't want to be holding up the leader. And Westy's going, yeah, right on. That helps. A little bit of breathing room, at least for a lap or two. Smythe can regroup once Krylov gets through. There is Krylov, so he's gotten around Smythe, and now he's going to pressure up ahead. And yes. Ready. Wow. 5 seconds back, and he's again in some laps of the car. It's a little confusing, so I'm gonna hit the tab again to see kind of who's who here. But meanwhile, the dogger battle is real. These guys, 14 to 15, they're within a second of each other. There is dogger battle. Oh, as you can see, the pits there. Ready going in for pits. I'm afraid he's going to finish the last 20 minutes of this race with some fresh rubber, or maybe he needed repairs. That spin might have been what made him decide to get his butt into the garage and get that fixed. So Freddy is getting passed up in the pit. That moves Woody up into 7th now. Baldoni in 6th. Goes through the lap cars here. Yep, that's Randy. Good looking car. Those MRG skins are fantastic. So Randy, hey, I'm gonna get my lap back if I can here. But Baldoni in that Ferrari should be able to get his way. So that's a lap track battle. Here he is, the battle for 10th. And ninth, Freddy Hell. Give him hell, Freddy. Trying to defend from Pilcher. Pitchler in that Merc. Oh, there we go. So does Philip have anything for him? They're coming up straight. Oh, that's a good exit by Freddy. Got in it early. Still looking to close that gap. If anything, it's growing. Nope, there it goes. It's coming down a little bit. Nope, it's growing. Meanwhile, Jones in front of these guys. Jones has pretty much clear sailing now in 8th place. He's come 8 seconds ahead of Freddy and that group. So, not a lot there. But back here in the back of the pack, we've got a really good battle going on here with Estrella and Upham. Paul in that Mustang. Chasing that Bezzarini. I believe that's what that is. Mateus, oh, he's closing. Look at that horsepower. Holy smokes, has he got a run here? Let's see what happens. This is fourth. 18. Is he going to fly by as the leader's coming out of the pit? So two stops for the Krylov and the leader gets finished. Krylov speeding in pit lane. Oh, my goodness. That is going to turn this race on its head. Krill speeding pit lane. Hello. How you doing? Corey's not happy at all about that, but what a move by Upham. And you guys are still duking it out. Stas coming back around. Inside that American Muscle Mustang. Wow, wow, wow. With that 289, opening it up. These guys are duking it. Oh, and he loses it. Matean got a little sideways there. But what is going to happen now? The thrill. There is thrill right there. Fresh out of the pit with tires, but a drive-through awaits. Unless it was some kind of a glitch. Wow. Paul defending Mateus. Oh, and Paul puts it off. The leader there, what in the heavens to Betsy? Going to the outside, but he's letting the blue flag. That's a good way to do it there. Didn't really lose too much time. Just swing it outside, let the leader through. But the leader for how long? Actually, he's only the leader through the pit stop. Gutierrez is leading this race, but has yet to make a second stop, which I don't know if it's necessary or not, but a lot of guys have done two stops already, so I'm thinking it might be. These guys let it through. Meanwhile, the top six, and here is Snake Wacko Missouri chasing the other Cobra for that sixth position. He's got it under a second. Holy smokes! Woody gets a little crazy there. They're maintaining position. Meanwhile, but this battle is heated up now. Mateus looking for a way around that Mustang. And here comes for the drive through now. So there goes Krill doing his drive through. Speeding. Oh man. Oh man. Is that for the smile on Gutierrez's face? Holy fuck. So nicely done. Penalty cleared. So let's see. There is Gutierrez. And Talvitier is some 20 something second back. So Talvitier must have pitted as well from second place. That has to be the gap of a pit stop. It's the battle for fourth between Vandergies and Talvitier. About a 5 second gap. Not unattainable, but a pretty good cushion for John Vandergies holding on to that third place left up on the podium. And we are under 15 minutes at the 13 minute mark. We get a quick cheat here. Okay, that was Summers. So Talvitier is coming through some lap track. Getting his way through. But meanwhile, this battle back here of Mateus and Upham continues. Let's cheat a little bit there. And these guys are getting the blue flag now from Dogger, who's trying to just get away around. Good place to get by here. Let him go by on the straight. And De Silva gets a penalty. Gills. Oh, Gills, another speeding pit lane. Now, reminder, these cars do not have rev speed limiters. So these are not modern race cars. You have to just know the RPMs and the speed and not go over it. And you can see it's costing these guys big time. Especially the pole sitter and leader of most of the laps in this race who had to serve himself a driver. These guys are duking it out, but I think 17, 20, and 2, and they're good. The lead, Tony's getting through. Don't hit him. Don't hit him. Don't hit him. Oh, no. Oh, no. Get out there, Tony. Talvitier. Come on. Oh, Tony. We're going to hear about that one. Oh, poor Gills not doing anything intentional. It's just there's only room for so many. That bumps Vandergies up in a second. Oh my goodness. Gutierrez with just under 12 minutes left. Gutierrez is sitting in the catbird seat now. Holy smokes. Man, Talbitier, I'm sure, is not very happy. And I can understand, but I didn't see nothing done on purpose there. It's just, man, you got to put these cars on the apex, right, to make the turn. And so he's coming in now. So maybe he needed tires anyway, though. And also, is De Silva's coming in, too. De Silva might be just giving himself a drive-thru. The Racing Online rules are, nope, he's actually in a stop. Okay, so WGA in a stop. Okay, well, there is your leader, Gutierrez, and coming up on the 11-minute mark. So meanwhile, Westy and Merritt are in a battle for 15th and 14th. Merritt currently holding that 14th spot. Oh, and it's still like another penalty. Just can't keep his foot out of the gas in there. He's going to have to do another drive-thru. Oh, get a little lag happy. Meanwhile, got Westy. Okay, here comes the... Now Talbiti has got himself behind more lap traffic. He's going to find himself in another mess. Filcher gets a penalty. I'm telling you, man. There's no rev limiters on these babies. You got to keep it under. So how many pit lane penalties are we going to have? Silva. You guys are just duking here. We got two for position. Merrick and Westy with the leader coming through, second place car, one of the leaders. Oh, she's sideways. We're getting frosted up in there. Nicely done. Westy goes sideways. Merrick's got the spot. He's got Silva to get around. And then we got Talbitier to get around all of them. It looks like Tony's just going, okay, you guys sort this out, then I'll get through. Coming down, we're under 10 minutes. What a chain of events here. It's like De Silva's peace, love, I'm coming in for my drive-through. Good heavens to Betsy. That is some crazy stuff. Okay, now let the lapper through. Here we go. And there he goes, Talbitier. Man, he was looking good up there. Had that little bit of collision with Gills. Oh. Not intentional. It's just the way it goes sometimes. Merrick is trying to get around. Here he goes. He's got to run. Oh, keep it clean, keep it clean. And with Westy duking it out. Onto it, Randy. He's got a pretty good run here. He can stay with it. Looking for it. Taking the inside. He's got his buddy. He can't himself up. Gets around Westy. Putting himself in this 12th spot. Nicely done. I had a feeling that he got that. Westy's coming back. On the outside, and he gets the speed coming down the hill and takes it right back. Well, something's up there with Merritt. He just lost out. Freddie Hill gets around him, his teammate. Maybe that was it. He was letting his teammate through. But what seemed to be a pretty tight battle, he's like, Westy just blew by him on the straight there. Here's Rizzi back here, one of the other MRG drivers. Pilcher and Wynnum, ongoing battle for that 14th spot. Oh, we've got two more out. We got Severstein, Jagati, and Martin all out of this race now. So Ben Summers joins them as well. So Summers is out. Wow. All right. We have three DNFs. Not four now. We have four. Taylor Severstein is out. Jagati is out. And now the latest is Summers. So try to keep up with all the action, but it's freaking impossible. This is the closest battle on here, but Krill has now found himself 10 seconds back with 6 minutes to go. So the drive-thru has cost him this race, I believe. It's Gutierrez well out in front, some 10 seconds. Unless by some miracle, Gutierrez could have an off. I don't know if Gutierrez has stopped. Let's see if this will show us how many top stops. Yeah, Krylov has two. He's, oh, Gutierrez is stopping now. Holy smokes, is that going to open the door for Krylov? Krylov going to survive the drive-thru? I believe he might. Holy smokes. Here he comes. There's the difference. So Johnny's coming. Where is Johnny now? All right. It showed him in the pit stop. Here, I think it's just a, I think it's a glitch. I'm gonna refresh the overlays. Yep, just a glitch. My bad. 15 seconds off. So the software sometimes just kind of steps on its face, and that's okay. I mean, I think the 397 devs added this broadcasting software, which was really cool. But nobody maintains it. There's only one page of documentation on it, and we talk about it. There's a few of us in the RF2 Discord, you know, we're kind of asking questions, how does this work? And we just get crickets, nobody knows, because I think that dev that put it in there is no longer with them. And they got bigger fish to fry now with Le Mans, which is a brilliant sim, by the way. It's really making strides. I raced some last night in the protos. It was so fun. Oh my gosh. There's people having issues, but I myself have not had any. If you have an up-to-date modern system, it's going to crank. You know, some of the older systems might struggle a little bit, but I got to tell you, that Le Mans is really a good, you know, really realistic graphics. I love the way the cars feel. But anyway, I digress. We have hit the 3.5 minute mark here in the next 10 seconds. And the current battles out here, we have Kasupi and Wood battling for 7th. Oh, we got somebody else on the track. They completely lost it. What's that? Oh my gosh, there was somebody in the Ferrari. I can't find him, but you saw it. Was it Giuseppe himself? I think it was. He's backed himself up to Jones now. Freddie Hill finds himself still maintaining in that top 10. He's 6th place. Nicely done. WTA recovering from the collision with Gills. Still in 6th position. So he's on his way to bring home some points as we are under 3 minutes. Mateus and Upham are battling for those points. 17th and 18th. The points pay all the way down, so we should be okay. Upham getting in front of Mateus again. These guys have had a great fight. So perhaps the points only pay down the top 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, it's only the top 10 that get points. So F1 stops scoring. 25 for the winner, 1 for 10th place. I believe that's how I'm reading it. 18 for second, 15 for third, 12 for fourth. You guys are duking it out now. good side-by-side racing as Estrella gets the spot. They trade places right there. Let's see if the Mustang can come back on the straight like we saw before. Here we go. So he's got that inside move. Look at that. The horsepower just takes it away. Great ball stop there. Mr. Upham. Getting 17 back. I think Westy and Merrick also in on this mix. Merrick's got a little bit of trouble on the straights, I think. Maybe he's got tires, but he is currently in 13th. As you can see, the 12th car, place car, some 4 seconds ahead. I think it's in front of the battle that's going on in front of him, where Upham is maintaining that spot. As we are down to the last minute, as the clock is ticking down, 50 seconds to go in round one. What a battle it has been.
Ooh.
Telling you, Gutierrez some 11 seconds out in front of Krylov. So it indeed was the mistakes down pit lane have once again changed the outcome of a race, as Johnny Gutierrez is going to win round one at awesome 76 Kyalami. Gonna have one more lap to go, I believe, unless the clock ticks out. I'm seeing sector two there. Yeah, I think this could be it. This could be the last lap. But Brady Hill and Tony are in a duke, in a battle here. But let's see, let's watch Johnny take the checkered here as he's coming up the hill for the last time. And then we'll get back to the Freddie Hill, who's not too far behind him. Here it is, round one goes to the Cobra, driven by Johnny Gutierrez. What a great job. And he is racing for Flying Crowbar Racing Team. Take the first win. Woohoo! Way to go! That is my team, by the way. Nice job. And here comes Stoney in second place. Krill in that Mustang. And Gills in that. There's your second place, Gills. Krill, pardon me. And then here comes the Cobra. The snake eyes of Michael Mazurek gets the third place on the podium. Nicely done. He did have a nice qualifier. Vander Gies with a brilliant run in the Ferrari. Nice clean run for John. Finishes fourth. And then Calvitie. Hey, nicely done. Freddie Hill coming across in sixth. Neil Wood gets a seventh place. Ed Jones in the Corvette, finishing top 10, eighth. Brilliant race in that bet. The only bet in the race. Way to go, Ed. Nicely done. Giuseppe Baldoni, he's going to finish ninth with Smythe right behind him in 10th. Christian Dogger picking up 11th place. Nicely done. Randy Merrick finishing 12th. But Randy, love the skins for those MRG guys. Really nice. And Westy finishing 13th, just ahead of Philip Pilcher, who has parked it. And Ale Basson, great job by Ale, 15th, and Wyndham in 16th. So nicely done, gentlemen. Very exciting race. What a man! I can't wait for 2 weeks. When we all head out to the next round. Right, in 2 weeks, we'll be at Oakton Park. It's going to be something else. Wow. What a race, man. That was something else, I'm telling you. I loved it. I loved every minute of it. Super fun. Let's see if... should be a result. I don't think. Race results. I want the regular results. But there you have it. There it is. That'll work. 40 lap. Wow, look at that. Johnny Gutierrez, Krylov, Michael Mazurek, John Vander Geest, Freddie Hill, Neil Wood. There is your top 10. What a race, everybody. Can't wait for the next one. I hope you guys had as much fun as I did. It's been blah, blah. And, yeah, check it out. Take care and check out these old tunes as we say goodbye for today, and we will see you in 2 weeks.